We can talk the facts, mean the facts, the truth. The only thing no one has a choice in is the truth. We could have sugarcoated, it wouldn't sound as harsh, poured some Clorox on it, it wouldn't look as dark. Suppress a whole generation and act surprised when they ask to talk. Try to hide the harsh truths from this generation.
Viewer discretion is advised, but there's no parental lock on problems.
No matter your age, it's hard to avoid them, especially when you see those problems in yourself. Can you relate? No matter relation, because nothing starts affecting you personally until it happens to your people, right?
Someone who looks like you, your age, your color, change what is into realities. What it is your voice. This is our voice.
We bring you the statistics, the big picture.
We tell you these things, but they were already sitting in your living room.
Bust through your door without invitation. Your daughters, your sons, we invite you to listen.
Shh.
Everybody listen.
The statistics are talking.
Suburban.
If you don't smile, you're mean.
And if you smile too much, you're fake.
And if you like to eat, then you're fat.
And if you don't, you're anorexic.
If less than half of the student population doesn't know your name, then you're a loser.
If you haven't had your first date by sixth grade, then you're bound to be hashtag forever alone.
Why are we bound by these superficial rules just to be cool or normal? Adults would say,
just be yourself.
But we feel pressured to fit in into what magazines and TV shows as the ideal. In order to be in this show, your personality has to be summed up into one word.
You're a hipster.
A skater.
An emo.
Or a prat.
A jock.
Or nerd.
It's ridiculous, because nobody is that stereotypical in cookie cutter. Whatever you do, don't draw attention to yourself, which can make things hard if you happen to be
shy.
Or gay.
Transgender.
Brain.
Or big bone.
Don't spend your life trying to fit into a category, because once you do, you've lost what made you, you. You can like nice things without being a prep, and you can like dark culture without being emo. Why do we treat each other like we're in a TV show? We are not based off of those characters. They are supposed to be based off of us, but some teens act like they're permanently caught in their own cheesy TV show.
You can put a label on me if you want, but just know I'm going to tear it off, because I'm way more than your best guess at what to expect. Some will call me weird, but I prefer unique. Yet you're just the same as me. The difference lies deeper than the eye can see, because visually, I am just another person. But in my soul, I am a work of art that has yet to be completed. So if you label me, best leave it blank, because whatever you write will be deleted. And you can say what you want, I'll remain undefeated. And I know you can dish it out, but can you eat it?
The three leading causes of death for CMS teenagers are accidents, suicide, and homicide. If you are a black male teen, that order is reversed.
Race is a sensitive topic. I see it everywhere. On my TV, in the media, heck, even in my street. Another dead black teen.
People say all lives matter, but it really doesn't change.
The fact that life for a minority differs greatly.
The fact that Joey is more likely to have a higher paying job than me.
The fact that I'm more statistically prisoned than college bound.
More likely to be falsely convicted for a felony. More likely to live in poverty.
More likely that we, the minority, to keep the prisons at 60% capacity. The fact that we live very different realities.
The fact that I'm an endangered species. Black teens who live to see 18, I'm in danger.
I feel no safety, not even in my own community, because if I am killed,
it'll likely be by someone who looks just like me.
I changed the world around.
I have time because I'm quickly running out of time.
And I'm screaming.
Not because I'm angry, but because I need you to hear me so that we can meet.
A mutual understanding, don't misunderstand me. Yes, we have come a long way,
but we are still too far to recall.
I'm just hoping that these words can bring us closer to seeing eye to eye.
Either.
I shouldn't have to watch a show.
night. I should be free. I shouldn't have to carry weapons to prevent attack. As children, we are told, boys will be boys. But when do boys turn into men?
A man asks for consent doesn't pressure. A man compliments doesn't harass.
A man respects my choices doesn't force me to live by his. Every walk to my car, every night when I'm out with friends, every time my guard is down just a little bit, this poison, boys will be boys, seeps in.
Why am I told to cover the skin I live in when boys are encouraged to stare?
I am not my gender, not my sex.
I am done being a girl. I am a woman.
A woman. Doesn't feel pressure, doesn't give in.
A woman owns her body, doesn't feel shame.
A woman makes decisions for herself, doesn't let society pressure her.
I am a woman.
Now grow up and become a man.
Check out our latest sex and relationships edition. Now that's what I call Teen Bop 25. featuring hits like STDs by Burnout Girl. Are sold.
Down. two lines.
Charlotte's weather is so bipolar!
These labels can be used to describe
describe what I may have. My disease or disorder does not define me. My disease or disorder is just a part of who I am. It does not decide who I am.
I am more than a label or a diagnosis. So don't use it to describe us. We have a name.
I'm Xavier.
I'm Emily.
I'm Julia.
We may have a disorder, but our disorders don't have us.
Patient 762, it's time for your weigh-in.
God, I hate my thighs. I wish I had a thigh gap. And my shoulders. I actually look like a linebacker.
Where did that zip come from? Jeez, my face is in there.
I feel like I have weird ears. I have weird ears.
Does every teenager on the planet feel this way? I think so. I mean, all my friends are beautiful, but they look in the mirror and they do exactly what I do. They critique. They judge every single part of themselves, parts that other people don't even notice. When they look at themselves, I honestly don't see what they see.
Oh my God, I'm so pale. I actually look like a ghost.
My face is so big. My boobs are so small.
My face is so white.
What is it about teens that we feel the need to constantly bring ourselves down? I mean, I can't be the only one that can't bring herself to accept a freaking compliment. Do you know that you're beautiful? Do you know that you're perfect just the way you are because you are? It's okay to not have problems with your ears or your weight or your voice. It's okay to not have a thigh gap. We all have something that makes us beautiful. You do us all a little good if we try a little harder to recognize it.
No more, so love yourself.
friend of mine gave me this. I told him I was having a good time at the party. He handed me this and said it would make things even better. But will it really? Because every time I see someone smoking, they just look stupid. You know, I've always been an okay student, never really got into any kind of trouble. My friends tell me I should cut loose every once in a while, but I don't think I should cut loose, at least not like this. I mean, or should I? If all my friends are doing it, why should I be the one missing out? They say it's fun, but every time I see someone getting high, every single time, they have this weird blank look on their face. And I can't have a conversation with them because they're too high to pay attention. If I say no to this, what's the worst that could happen? Might call me a couple names, make fun of me a little, call me uptight, but if that's what it takes for me not to be like them, I think I'd be okay with that. And honestly, if they're my real friends, they'd be okay with that too.
Broken toys held together by glue and tape, worn with time and covered in mistakes, we're all living to die. But really, we're all dying to live. We say we're all grown up, but really, we're just kids. We want to change the world. Hashtag forever young.
You may be playing Peter Pan, but Tink isn't here to make you fly. So you got yourself some pixie dust that'll take you just as high. You're slowly destroying yourself, but I guess you just don't mind. You're digging your own grave and building yourself a persona to hide behind. You're rebelling.
Against what?
Who is the enemy?
Because as far as we can tell, the only one harming you is yourself.
Hey, teens! Feeling the urge to get lit with your friends? Well, Teen Bop has a new collection of songs just for you! Teen Bop, Druggie Remix Part 1, featuring hits like Slow Killer by Kanye West.
You ain't got no money!
I ain't saying it's a slow killer. The cigarettes will make you choke.
No,
I ain't saying it's a gold digger. Cigarettes will make you broke. You can't breathe me to death. You can't breathe me to death. You can't breathe the love of breath. You can't breathe the love of breath.
Watch Me Sip by Silent Throw Up. I Don't Smoke With You by Sig Sean.
I don't smoke with you.
You looking dumb, no lungs.
I ain't smoking with you.
Black lips, no fun.
I ain't smoking with you.
I got a job and some plans and some other things to do.
Then I'll be smoking with you.
You looking stupid, smile.
I'll hit the blunt.
Stitches by Shawn Mendes.
Needle in the vein, gonna get you out of my pain. Needle in the vein, going straight to my brain. Needle in the vein, gonna get you out of my pain. Needle in the vein, going straight to my brain. Needle in the vein, gonna get you out of my pain. Needle in the vein, going straight to my brain. Needle in the vein, gonna get you out of my pain. Get you out of my pain. You got me high, but now I can't breathe. Shaking, falling onto my knees. And now that I'm without your needle, but you're lethal. I'm no longer myself, begging, begging for someone to help. Now that I'm without your needle, I need you, but you're lethal.
Teen Bop. Honestly, getting lit isn't worth all of this.
So kids, why are drugs bad for you?
Well, drugs are like medicine, which is nasty, but makes your head go woo, woo.
No, they make you crazy.
Yeah, they make you crazy, like boop, 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 boop.
Totally make you crazy.
Well, drugs are bad because they make you die.
Are you sure you guys aren't on drugs?
No.
Pressure the light up, getting you down. Well, don't worry, Teen Bop has a new collection of dope songs. Just for you. Teen Bop, Druggy Remix Part 2, featuring hits like My Last Friday Night by Katy Scary.
Now this is gonna kill me. I can't see myself stopping. I need to kick this habit, or else I will be dropping. I know I got to get right now, cause I can't get much stronger. Only got one night left now. Drugs just keep getting stronger.
Don't you tell me! Don't you tell me!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Teen Bop, I don't get paid enough to promote this.
sip me, drink me. Pass me to your friends, let's all be friends. We've only just begun. And you're not 21, but age is just a number. Sip some more. Notice how you're no longer in control. Let me compliment your vulnerability. I mean, it was easy to get in your system, start making your decisions, can never really forget first impressions. And you'll probably try to quit me soon. I mean, they all do, but I'll keep calling and calling and calling because you know when your hotline blings, it only means one thing. I miss you. How long have we been friends? Trust me, I won't hurt you. Don't ruin the party. I make really good decisions. Of course you can drive. We'll be home in no time. Swerve a little, have some fun. It's only a life. I'm sorry. I always forget to introduce myself. I'm alcohol, and you won't be making it home tonight.
It was a cool night as Alice and Jake and I walked, barely walked, to my mom's car. We all piled in laughing. You know, there was a reason we were laughing, but I can't remember that now. The car started and we took off. The vibe was good. I could feel the music vibrating through my body. I closed my eyes, rolled down the windows, and I could feel it. The wind, the music, the world around me. I felt invincible. And in that moment, I was immortal. And then I opened my eyes, saw white lights that blinded me, and then bam! I felt the car levitate off of the road. Everything was in slow motion until the airbag exploded in my face. When I came to, I could see flashing red and blue lights. Policemen were standing around and medics were lifting me up onto a gurney. Out of the corner of one eye, I could see Allison face first on the asphalt, a trail of red skin and bones behind her. She was a beautiful girl. I looked around for Jake, but I couldn't find him before I blacked out. When I came to, I was in a hospital, and medics had informed me that Allison was dead and that Jake would never walk again. If only I didn't listen to them. Allison and Jake told me that everything would be fine and that getting caught only happens to other people. If only I hadn't gone to a party knowing that there would be alcohol. I've ruined the lives of two of my best friends. Allison is dead. And Jake will never walk again while what? I get to walk away undamaged? Now I have to live the rest of my life knowing what I've done. If only I had just said no.
Why? That's the first question anybody asks when they find out. Why would you hurt yourself? I never know what to say. I mean, it took so long to get over it and it was so hard to stop, yet people keep bringing me back to that one question. Why?
If I had been able to figure out all the reasons I was hurting, I never would have cut myself in the first place. Nobody really understands. I mean, I must have been asked by countless people. Everyone I told, everyone I opened up to, they all wanted to know one thing. Why?
I don't know. I didn't know then, and I don't know now. Even though I've been able to stop and try to talk it out and get help, I still can't figure out why.
It was an impulse. It just happened, and after it happened once, it kept on happening. It was like I lost control for this short period of time, and I couldn't stop my hands from doing what they were doing. It scares me to think how easy it was.
Cutting's not that much different from a drug addiction, I'm told. Because you know what you're doing is bad and wrong, and it's hurting you. It's literally hurting you, yet you feel this overwhelming need. I still feel that need from time to time. It doesn't completely go away. But I've realized that I'm stronger than that. So I think the question that we should be asking isn't why, but what are the reasons that I should stop?
And even if I can't explain why, if I can just help one person because I've experienced what they're experiencing, because I've been where they are, then I don't think why matters.
Just do something that you know could redirect your attention. Sometimes I'll hold a bag of ice, or I'll have a rubber band, and whenever I get the urge, I'll snap it.
Whenever I feel like cutting, I try to imagine myself having to explain the scars on my arms and legs to the children I want to have one day. I know it's hard, but there are a lot of people who have been there and can support you.
Just know that you can get help, and it does get better.
I'm happy, right? I've got a good family, great friends, so I'm happy, right? Well, it's hard to be happy when the chemicals in my brain have become unbalanced, like a scale
with a rock on one side
and a feather on the other.
My inner child has taken up residence on the swing sets in my mind labeled mood. I can put on a smile, laugh, joke with my friends, but I go home and
cry, scream
silently while my parents watch TV in the other room.
They don't know that my unmarked skin hides scars deeper than you can see.
I only let them out when I'm in the dark of my room, crying myself to sleep, only barely hanging on.
It's hard to be the support when you're cracking apart, but I'm still the least broken, so I keep my friends in one piece, putting them back together with duct tape and paper clips.
While ignoring the faults of my own foundation.
They don't know that I'm falling apart, and the only reason they don't know
is because I've sewn this mask to my face so you can't see the cracks in my facade, but I know they're there. Just under the surface, and it's hard to fix something you don't acknowledge, but someone's torn down the wallpaper, showing off my faults, and suddenly, there's a construction crew held together by duct tape and paper clips, coming in with hammers and nails, here to piece me back together, and if I let them, they can patch up the cracks in my soul. Keep me together long enough to find a solution, or at least something more permanent than duct tape and paper clips. But for now, they'll do, and I can take my mask off.
Knowing I have friends
who can help with these cracks.
And I'll be happy, right?
I should have seen it coming. The warning signs were all there. The late night fights, the tension at the dinner table. Dad said he was just busy, but 9 to 5 became 6 to 11. If he came home at all, he was tense and disheveled. I'd be lucky if he even acknowledged me. Then one day, suits and ties gave way to empty hangers. That night, Mom set out 2 plates instead of 3. There was no small talk, no awkward conversation, just a silent understanding. The bags under her eyes told me everything. But now I carry the bags inside of me as I wonder if I'll ever be able to have a healthy relationship myself. They say that children of divorced parents are 7 times more likely to suffer from depression. I never thought I'd be part of that statistic.
Hey, how's it going?
Look, I don't want to spend any more time on the same old subject, so why am I out here?
We haven't spoken in almost 3 years, and now you just magically expect for me to let you back into my life. Why should I? You were wrong for what you did, and you know it's all coming back to you.
Let's see. Who's my favorite singer? What's my favorite subject in school? You can't tell me, can you? I thought so. Look, I'm not here to make you hurt more than you've made me hurt, but...
You lost the one person who loved you and believed in you no matter what.
Do you have any idea how weird it is for me to go into a barbershop and not have you there? There's all these kids with their dads, and I'm just there alone.
Do you have any idea how bad it hurts not to be able to go to a daddy-daughter dance because I don't know where you are?
Did you know I got my first job this summer? No.
Do you know I can drive now? No.
Am I in a relationship? No.
You don't know me at all. And you want to know why? Because you never cared to know.
No phone calls, no emails.
No nothing.
Just pain.
So you tell me what I should do.
You were supposed to teach me how to be a man and how to treat a lady, but all I ever learned was what not to do.
A father is supposed to teach his little princess how to be treated like a queen, but how was she supposed to know that when the king left the castle?
All I ever asked was that you never leave, and you left.
So we can wrap up this conversation.
Because you have no idea
what it means to be a father.
Repeat.
I'm a product of my surroundings. Just a painting of a bounding. Even our expression is unidentifiable, but you cannot hold me liable. I'm just a product of my surroundings.
The screen illuminates my face. It's my saving grace. I don't know how to think anymore. I don't know what I'm sitting here for. The screen has all the answers. The screen has all the jokes. The screen is the only reason I awoke.
I don't understand why you're angry.
I can't comprehend what you mean. Are we not the age of evolution, the cyborgs of society? I've sold my soul to the almighty cloud. Thousands of us lay flat along the hard drive. I assume that's life.
I stay up watching YouTube because I don't know day from night. My body clocks are off and my eye muscles are tight. But forget school, who needs it? I can type faster than I can write.
I am part of an online community, a unity, assuming we never meet face to face. I was programmed to assert opinion and receive hate. Twitter is how I think. Snapchat is how I see.
Instagram
is how I know which one I'm supposed to be because
all cyborgs look exactly the same.
Inviting each other to play games, I have Candy Crushed any means of individuality. Digital is my reality.
Wake Sarah,
shut down!
Please hold down power button for shutdown.
Error, you cannot reset life. Last week is gone. Last month is gone. You were too busy staring at the screen that it forwarded right past you. Full throttle. Life traded you in for a newer model with more gigs and a smaller attention span.
And our generation speaks.
Emojis got our vocabulary sloppy.
And we say, wow, we could have been somebody.
Hey, teens. Stop stressing and start pressing. The play button, that is. On Team Bob's latest collection of songs just for you, featuring hits like Hotline Bling by Fake.
Stop. Oh, I'm totally driving, but it's fine.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
While I was driving on the road, I'd snap you on my cell phone.
Oh no!
Did I do that?
Aye, aye, be cheating.
Yes.
So I cheat, yeah, just cheating on the down low, and I don't want my teacher to know. So I cheat, yeah, because I didn't study, and I don't want my teacher to know. Oh, so I cheat, oh God, oh God.
Teacher's writing. Study group? Failed course by Katie Scarry.
So you wanna pass your classes? You don't even know what to study for. 50 on your report card. Now you're looking at a failed course. Now you're ready for summer school. If you wanna
I call her mama.
When
I don't do my work,
here come that drama.
You better
study
better.
See you again, my bed by Charlie's Pooped. I don't get paid enough to promote this.
Bullets have no name. Maybe that's why so many of my friends are gone, because bullets had no name and theirs was so special that they took it from them. But they take so much more. They take a son from a mother, a brother from a sister, and a friend from me. As the tears fall down my face like a tiny avalanche onto yours, I can only think about last night. I grabbed the drinks, you grabbed the condoms, you headed to the front, you said, "Hey, yo, let me get two of them swishes," because I caught the dub from JJ earlier. Next stop, the girls we hollered at. You know I went to Keisha, and Tammy was always thirsty for you, so it was a no-brainer. But maybe if we used our brain, we would have realized that their brother was the same guy my cousin robbed last week. Why did I have to be with him? He's always getting into something. I guess today's my lucky day, huh? His voice only reminded me of that day. Hey, where y'all from? Go inside your pockets. You can't hear me, I said, where y'all from? Take them J's off too. Now get out of here. The only difference between then and now is then I heard his feet hitting the ground. Now I hear bullets piercing through the car door. Bang, 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 bang. Three inside your thigh, two inside your chest, and one grazing your eye. As we pull off to the hospital with blood everywhere, the doctor says you'll be blind in your right eye and that you lost two fragments in your chest. He won't remove them because you lost enough blood. But you're here with me, your mom, and your little sister. You're gonna make it, you're gonna make it. But as I chant, there's this faint noise. What is this noise? Oh, flatline. You're gone. How could you be gone? Your birthday was gonna be Saturday. Your mom was gonna send her 18-year-old son off to college. Instead, she's getting her 8-year-old ready for the second grade with her outfit. Red chucks, black jeans, and a black shirt that says R.I.P. Robbie with your face on it. And on the back, bullets have no name.
There was a lot of blood in the sink and bruises all over my body. He kept on screaming about how useless and stupid I was. I thought my mom would understand, but she blames me too. They all do. They say if I keep it up, they'll kick me out, but if I run away, I'll be charged on terms of undisciplined. But if I was 6 or 7, I wouldn't have this problem at all. Everyone would just swoop in and save the poor innocent child being beaten for no reason. But because I'm 15, they say I should just shut my mouth and be respectful. So my mouth is to blame, and not them. Not their words, not their actions, not their fists, but me. So either I can stay and be completely miserable and beaten, or I can leave and go God knows where. And sometimes I actually think it is my fault. That maybe this wouldn't be happening to me if I were a little different. That maybe I'm doing something wrong. That maybe I deserved it. That maybe I should let the bruises stay, because they seem to be the only ones that really know what happened.
I remember the closet. It was such a tight space in there. Turn on the lights, I'm hiding behind my lies, hung up on coat hangers, suffocating me. I want to reach a hand out so you know that I'm there. I used to hide my true self in there, and it's a secret I'm afraid to share, because if I tell you, it'll change your perception, make you think I led you to believe I'm somebody different, and I'm sorry. I only act closeted because that's what I am. And I've never found the courage to turn on the lights and let you know that I'm hiding my true self in the closet. I want to knock, scream for help, let you know that we are suffocating. And this won't be easy for any of us, but
we're claustrophobic.
Now you feel the awkward silence of hypocrisy.
That silence you feel every time you hear someone say,
"Man, that's gay."
Or, "That's a sin."
Or worst of all,
"It's wrong just because it's wrong."
Why do homophobia and hypocrisy go together so well?
It's a perfect fit.
We all think we know what we're talking about.
But do we?
Do we really?
Everybody's always got something to say.
Everybody's got their own opinions.
Until it's you.
Or your best friend.
Uncles.
Mommies.
Daddies. Cousins.
Boyfriends and/or girlfriends.
I am me, not my sexuality.
You call us Ryan.
Dax.
And Naila.
Not those straight people.
So why is it okay to say that lesbian chick?
Or that gay guy.
Or which one, the bi one?
We need to take a step back.
Look at the big picture.
How would you feel if it were you?
You who lost your job.
Your friends.
Your scholarship.
You
would
feel
insulted.
So the next time you say something and think that you're just joking,
take a moment of silence.
When you look at me, what do you see? You must see a monster. Well, whatever you see, that's not who I am. You laugh at me, you tease me, you call me names, names which will haunt me for the rest of my high school life. Why? That's the question. Why? Is it because of the way that I move, the way that I talk? What is it? I'm tired. Tired of saying one thing and then you feel you have to say something else to make me look stupid. Tired of being the laughing stock of the class. But you know what's really funny? Is that when you're alone, you say hi to me. But when you're with your friends, you laugh at me. But guess what? I don't need you. I mean, what you say affects me, but I'm not going to let it affect my life. Because you're certainly not going to be in my life 10 years from now, so why should I care now? Because what you think is weird, Somebody else thinks is cool, and what you think is ugly, someone else in the world thinks is the most beautiful thing. I'm not concerned about your thoughts and opinions because I'm focused on me, my goals, my life, my future. So if you have the time to talk about me behind my back, at least take the time to acknowledge me face to face. So now I ask you again, when you look at me, what do you see?
People always tend to ignore ugly things when we see them. We just put the blinders up and act oblivious to it. Most of the time, bullying is staring us straight in the face and we do nothing about it. I'm pretty normal, I guess. I don't bully people and I don't get bullied. I rarely see it happening at my school, but I think that's because I'm unaware I have my blinders up.
There was a time a few weeks ago in my English class. There was this girl behaving so rude and ignorant and offensive to the smaller, quiet, awkward girl. One day, the quiet girl raised her hand in response to the teacher's question, and the bully made fun of the way she talked and how stupid her answer was. We all laughed, and the teacher did nothing. You could tell that she was upset and embarrassed, but we just ignored it and laughed. This continued to happen for a couple more classes. Every time the girl raised her hand to answer a question or pretty much did anything, we just ignored it and laughed. I soon started to think, this girl is getting bullied. She doesn't like it, and she's in a helpless situation. Nobody in the class is on her side, and we all laugh, and the teacher ignores it. I felt like saying something, but I didn't. I didn't want to be weird or laughed at. I didn't do anything. Does that make me bad?
My mind tells me just to ignore, but my gut tells me to say something.
We all witness bullying, but we just ignore it, pass it on.
September 28th, dear diary. It seems like every time something bad happens, something good happens, something bad immediately follows right after. You'd think I'd be used to it, but can't help but want to cry. Sometimes I hate my parents. They go about life acting as if nothing's wrong, acting as if we're some one big happy family. They don't get it. They just don't get it. They don't get that they're the ones making me miserable. They don't get that they're one of the reasons why I'm depressed.
I'm sorry you feel like I didn't care.
I'll always care for you. I just wanted you to be happy.
I'm sorry if I ever made you feel unwanted or unloved.
November 30th. This would be hilarious if it wasn't so horrifyingly tragic. Every time something good happens to me, something bad immediately follows right after. Is it too much to ask for just one good thing? I think not. I could be wrong.
I just wanted to say that I will always love you.
You can always talk to me if you need me.
December 2nd. Sometimes I feel like there's no reason for me to live. I wish I could just cease to exist. I feel myself slipping. All the progress I've made is going down the drain, but who cares, right? It's easier this way. I would do anything to make this pain go away.
I'm sorry I ignored the signs.
I understand your pain.
You'll never be alone.
I'll always be there for you.
You are not alone.
January 3rd, dear diary, I feel angry, sad, confused. I feel lost, empty, devastated, but most of all, I feel empty. Empty, hollow, blank. I don't want to feel empty anymore. I want to enjoy life. I want help. I just don't want to admit it. I don't want them to put me in some kind of hospital, but maybe that's the kind of help I need.
It's okay to ask for help.
I'm sorry you felt like we hated you.
Everyone feels alone sometimes.
It would have gotten better.
January 30th, dear diary, I'm done. I'm done with life. I just don't know what to do anymore. I'm tired of everyone I know hating me. I'm tired of trying over and over only to fail every single time. I'm tired of being tired. No one would... No. No one will miss me when I'm gone. Just doing everyone a favor, right? So goodbye. Thanks for being there for me, diary. Thanks for being the only one that would listen.
February 2nd. It's been a month since it happened. Since she took herself away from us. There was so much that I wanted to tell her, but I never got that chance.
I wanted to tell her how proud of her I was.
I wanted to tell her that she would always be in my heart, and I'm sorry I didn't see what was going on.
I wanted to tell her that I'm sorry, and that I never meant to hurt her.
So why did you do it?
Why did you choose to leave us?
Why did you choose a permanent solution to a temporary problem?
Didn't you know how much we loved you?
Didn't you know how much we cared?
Did you not once stop to think how it would feel when you were gone?
What we would go through once you had left?
I wish you had failed.
I wish you had failed.
Why couldn't you have failed?
It's a weird feeling you get when you regret something that someone else did. It's even weirder because you regret that they did it to themselves. She mattered to me. She mattered to a lot of people, which is why we were all so confused. Confused because she always seemed so happy. Confused because she never told anyone. Confused because now we all have to refer to her in the past tense. It was just another day when I found out I felt a lot of things. And I cried, and I yelled, and I called her foolish, and I called her selfish, and I called her cruel, but in that moment she wasn't any of those things, she was just gone. And I blamed everyone. I blamed myself, and I blamed her. I still don't know why she did it, but everyone has their guesses. Well, she was so beautiful, they say. Yeah, well, I wish she had known. She was such a nice person, they say. Yeah, well, she hadn't thought so. She had such a big heart, they say. Well, it wasn't big enough to keep beating when she asked it to stop. Whatever her reasoning, I wish that I could have helped her. I know that I could have helped her because she mattered to me. And now, we all regret that she's gone. And she'll never know that what she did has hurt all of us.
Why won't they just leave me alone? I did nothing to them. They are so immature. I mean, like, I'm a good person, right? You know, I'm smart and I don't do anything to anybody, and then people just act childish all the time. You know, they don't own up to their mistakes, they bully me, and for what? I mean, I try to be nice to them. I don't know what else I can do. I just don't understand immaturity. You know, I bet, no. I hope
that someone say immature!
Millie, me!
That's me, and I have a fabulous new partner that everybody needs! Maturity!
How does it work?
I'm glad you asked! Just use one ounce of maturity, and you're mature!
Wow, so when somebody is acting childish?
Give them some maturity!
When people are owning up to their mistakes?
Give them some maturity!
When people are making fun of me?
Give them some maturity!
How much does it cost? Because I need some right now!
Just like the rest of my partners, it is $3.99!
I can definitely afford that, and I thank you and appreciate you so much, Millie Mays, because your products are always here to save the day!
Maturity, because everybody needs it!
Parents, my girl messing me up. I'm just stressed, man.
Man, don't worry about it. There's one thing you gotta worry about.
What is that, bro?
Hey, we gon' be alright. 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 Huh? We gon' be alright.
Initial applause, kids, aren't they not phenomenal?